everybody.
Hi guys.
Hi, my name is Erik.
I'm Ja.
Ja is new, so today he will do the chat.
Yeah, bear with me please.
Yeah, so in the coming weeks you will see more from Ja. We have some nice live streams planned. So today chat, also the giveaway, so important person. Make sure he's your friend. So today we're going to talk about our new Trident X. And first of all, we're going to do some, we will do some unboxing of Trident X. We have some benchmarks, and not only benchmarks, but also Call of Duty benchmarks, because we have a bundle, which will start, I think, somewhere this month. If you buy a monitor, a certain monitor, or let me see what it is. I think it's Aegis Ti-3.
Infinite X,
an 8 and 9 gen, and the new Trident X. Yeah. If you buy one of them, you get a free game code for Call of Duty. But so we are also going to give away some today.
Yeah, as you can see on the screen.
Yeah, we just noticed that this msi.com/2/insider is not working. So Ja will post some links in the chat.
So pay attention to the chats, please. I'll be regularly posting the links, so you can use that link instead.
And it's like each week, you know, just sign up and then from time to time we will draw a winner. If you're not watching live, each Wednesday we have a live stream, and each Wednesday we're giving away some game codes. Well, next week it will not be a game code, but that's for next week. Where to start with Trident X? I think I have this PC here.
Whoa. Oh, that's a big boy.
Yeah.
And I have something else here.
Small boy, right?
A bit smaller.
Yeah, so these are two of our, maybe you can remove the banner. So these are two of our gaming PCs. This is Aegis Ti-3, so it's a beast, as lie. And this is our small
Trident.
Yeah, Trident 3. Very compact size, size of a console. And we have something new. So maybe let me put this a little bit aside.
And this too, let's make some room.
It's not easy. So let's unbox this one. How does it work? Oh, these two. So we practiced this before, and yeah.
Let's see. I'll hold the box.
Maybe first take this one out.
Yeah. Some nice pizza in here.
And yeah. I think I take it out. Yeah.
Got it?
Yeah.
Alright.
Thank you. This. So what's inside? Let me see. Like this.
Ta-da!
That's your text, right? So this is our new Trident X, and as you can see, it sits in the middle. So this one is 10 liters. I don't know how much this is, but you know, a lot of liters. Yeah. And in desktop PCs, we always, you know, talk about liter size, and liter size is basically how much packs of milk you can pour inside. So this is probably 20, maybe even more. Yeah.
You'll probably pour some Diet Coke in there, but
yeah, indeed. And this is much smaller, of course. Like what I told you, this one can do SLI, so this one cannot. This one is much wider, so two GPUs can be inside this beast. Also, of course, a heavier power supply. This one, this is our, we also have an 8th gen with this, Intel 8th gen, we call it. With a GPU, can it go up to GTX 1070. And this is a mini ITX. Yeah. VJ card, so it's very small, and that's also, if you see this, you know, there's not actually, you see the VJ card here.
Yeah, you can see it.
Yeah, so it's very small, and you can upgrade this. I know there are some GTX 1080s on the market in mini ITX format, but that's it. And maybe, you know, if we talk about RTX 20 series, I'm not sure, I'm not allowed to talk what we are going to do in mini ITX, but for sure there will also be in these form factors. The benefit of this one, maybe remove this one. Leave that one there. The fan. Oh, sorry. Yeah, maybe. Yeah, because this one also comes with a power supply, and this one we already have the power supply built in.
So that's why, you know, the big difference in size.
Yeah, that's in size, also a full VJ card is in here. You have much more flexibility in this system. And you see a lot of systems on the market. And you know, they pretend to be small, but in the end, it's, you know, they have an external power supply. Some even have a dual power supply, quite big. Let me go sit down. So, any questions?
Well,
I see.
We had a question, but you already answered it, actually.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah, because somebody asked if it's upgradable. And yeah,
yes, so I'm going to show you how to upgrade. Let me unscrew this. So, let me put this at the bottom. So, here you have it. Maybe check the detailed cam. No detailed cam?
Yeah, it's coming up. Just a second.
Did we delete it or what? Oh, even don't do anything, please. Michiel is trying to fix it.
Well, the chat is
Michiel, stress!
Can you try to plug and unplug your webcam?
Oh, yeah, this one. And then all the settings might be different again. Yeah, there we have it. Cool.
Well, there are a few people asking about the Thunderbolt. Does it have Thunderbolt?
No, this system is for gaming and it doesn't have Thunderbolt. If you are interested in Thunderbolt, definitely watch next week. Because next week we're going to talk about content creation and X299. And then we have a lot of Thunderbolt. This system, you can see in here, it has a full-size, in this case, GTX 2080. It comes also with 2080 Ti or 2070. And for 2080 and 2080 Ti, we use Ventus VGA cards. And if you're talking about the 2070, we use an Armor VGA card. And even this one you can upgrade. So if I take off the top, I need to remember where I put all the screws. And that's it with what we try to do with our gaming desktops. Oh, so here you have it. So if you look at the top, the VGA card is locked here with some screws. And of course, at the top, let me see this way. So in here with two screws. So you can easily remove it, upgrade it. The Ventus, which is inside now, is two slots. A little bit thicker. Let's say 2.2 slots. I think you can fit in a 2.5, 2.7 VGA card, so you can upgrade it to a different format. I'm going to screw this back again.
Yeah. Someone is asking about the price, and I think you'll get to that later, or do you want to talk about it now?
Yeah, well, I can already mention price. We have a lot of different configurations. Later I will show you a slide. Depending on the region, we have different configurations, and the price starts, I think, in, let's say, US dollar, about $2,000 to $3,000, and I think we also have some more, me and a screwdriver. Let me see. We have like I think 10 or let's say 10 different configurations. This is not going well.
It's okay. Well, there's also someone asking if there's a Ryzen version. Well, at the moment we don't.
No.
Who knows? Maybe in the future.
Yeah, indeed. As you know, at this moment, Intel CPUs are very difficult to get. So at this moment, we're also looking into building some AMD versions. But this is for the future, not yet decided yet. Still something we're looking into. So over here, you also see the power supply. We have two different power supplies. This one comes with a 450 watt. And we also, what's the other one?
65.
650 watt indeed. So, and that depends on the configuration. Because this one has an i7 9th generation 9700 inside. We also have with the i9 9900K.
Yeah. And as you can see, well, not yet, but it's being air cooled because somebody is asking about the cooling.
I can turn around.
Let me
first
show
this.
We can show you later.
So this mainboard over here, I have actually here. This is our Z370i Gaming Pro Carbon AC. So let me take it out of the box. real quickly. Maybe you can show this cam. Yeah, so you see how small it is. This is really mini ITX. Of course, we modified the main board a little bit. We for example, this one has Wi-Fi on the I/O panel. This one doesn't have Wi-Fi on the I/O panel. We put it in the casing. There are some heat sinks, so we changed some small things. But basically, you get this motherboard, this PCB, and these kind of features. Let me have. So here also an M.2 slot for your M.2 SSD, NVMe based, Gen 3 X4 of course. You can easily upgrade it, replace it. Let's have a look at the other side. So today I need to unscrew a lot of screws. Maybe Jai, you can take the other webcam. Uh-huh. Let people see me. Okay.
Well, that wasn't that bad.
No, hey, already unscrewed. Okay, later we will see about the screws, yeah. Where they went. So like this. So here you see the main board at the bottom. Yeah, it's very difficult to see. And this is the this is the CPU cooler. And let me put some power on it. Power. Yes, thank you. So, because it comes with really nice RGB LED. Can we maybe show in the main cam?
We're getting quite a few compliments from people, so that's good.
I hope about cable management. So, on the other side, you also see some RGB LED. The green screen is messing it up.
But maybe we can see it better here.
Yeah, so, indeed.
Yeah, as you can see.
So let me talk about this side a little bit. The power supply over here, I already talked about the mainboard. The CPU cooler, it's a big fan. And if you remember Trident is a small fan, so it makes a lot more noise. So this is a very silent system. A bigger fan doesn't have to spin as much to replace the air. Here you can find two SSDs or hard drives, SATA drive base.
Yeah, 2.5 inches.
Yeah, 2.5 inch. So yeah, I don't have to unscrew this. I believe you can already see it sitting here. Most configurations we send out in one hard disk and one SSD. So the hard disk is for storage and the SSD is for speed. So and it depends on the configuration. I think 512 gigabyte SSD, and that's more than I think.
That's well. Depends on if you like, have 50 games on your computer. I mean, I guess in that case, yeah. Then no. But I think for an average
but,
user, yeah.
You can also work with Optane.
Yeah.
So if you want to boost your let me. This one wasn't really closed. And now, where's the pizza box?
Here is the pizza box.
Yeah.
Now I'm gonna show you something really nice. Let's get it cam.
Yeah. So, of course, no pizza. Otherwise, it would be already empty. By me?
Yep. So, as you can see, a really glossy, nice looking tempered glass.
Yeah. So, maybe take it out?
Yep.
So, it comes with a manual how to assemble. And we don't, maybe like this. We don't ship this one in the box, of course. Let's say we don't ship it assembled because otherwise, during logistics, it might damage.
Yeah. Damage,
so that's why you need to install it yourself. So maybe Jai, you can keep this, please. I have here already the screws, and it's a quite easy mechanism. The only factor, the problem is that I have to do it.
I have trust in you.
Yeah. Let me maybe in the detailed cam. I will show you the back. So over here, can you see it? Yeah. Over here, you have two holes and there is a hinge, which basically needs to be attached. Any questions?
Yes, Tian is asking, but can it run Crysis?
Oh yeah, it can do much more than Crysis.
And Marco is asking, when will it come out?
This one is already shipping, and I think in the US it's already in the stores, and in Europe it should appear quite soon in the stores. Best to check on the local MSI website or with the local MSI office when these are available. I don't know in APAC, so in Asia, Siamia, I don't know the exact dates. Am I doing this correctly? Yeah. Let me first focus at this, otherwise I think the glass will shatter. Okay. Maybe I shouldn't have, tightened them up.
Yep.
So now we have two small, very small, what is it? Hinges, I think you can call them.
Yeah.
Yeah, so you just put them in the, I don't know the English word.
Yeah, hinges.
Yeah, maybe the hinges. And then you can attach this panel to it, the door.
Yeah, as you can see, it's really easy. You just shove it in.
And then,
voila.
Yeah, let me take this indeed.
Yeah. So that's the hole, and here you can see.
Yeah, and with this you can very easy access all components inside. So there are magnets here. Let me show you this. On this side, here there are magnets inside, so it's it closes automatically. Now I have to put this one in again. So, like that. Quite nice. Maybe show the main cam again, and people can see it as well. Yeah. So it's included in each Trident X, and like what I said, we don't ship with it because it's quite fragile. That's why we have it in a separate box. And as you can see, it's quite easy to assemble. Even I can do it. We didn't tell them how many we broke, right?
Yeah, that's confidential.
Yeah. Let me also talk a little bit about the I/O ports. So at the front, you can this side. It's always difficult. Yeah. So at the front we have audio connectors for headset and microphone. We have two USB 3 Gen 1 connectors and we have a Type C connector. So a lot of accessibility there. Then in the back, I should power it down. That's the official way. Yeah. So, of course, on top you have the VGA card. This case is the 20. There we are. So it's much more easier. Yeah. So, on top of we have the VGA card. So it's much more easier. Oh, sorry. What's this? I thought it was going on. Power supply. So we have a VGA card, so this one 2080, so it comes with DisplayPort, HDMI connectors, no problem there. Type-C as well, but I think we're still far away from Type-C connectors. And then you have the mainboard. At the bottom you also have HDMI DisplayPort. We disabled them with a plug, so you can easily remove the plug and then still connect it. But that's more for debugging, because you will use the discrete graphics, the RTX 2080. Again, USB 3.1 Gen 2, Type-C, Type-A, Intel Gigabit LAN. We also have two extra USB 3.1 USB ports here. And then, 7.1 audio, and this is with, what is it?
Something minor.
Oh, one moment. Like this, and then like this. Okay, that's fixed. Also with SPDIF for the people who like that. So that's it. If there are no questions, maybe I will show a few slides, Ja.
Yeah.
Yeah, so we changed the webcam. Yeah, this one indeed. Ja? Yeah, you need to, yeah. So.
Yeah, there's some remarks in the chat.
About?
But generally, it's
anyway, any question?
Funny stuff, and if there's any important question, I'll just highlight
okay.
it.
Perfect.
But people really like the tempered glass.
Yeah, I also yeah. really like it, you know. It shows off the RGB LED. And later, I will show you in the software. We will boot up the system, we will capture it, and we will show you with the software how you can change the RGB LED. So let's talk a little bit what's inside,
yeah.
a few slides. First of all, the ninth generation Intel CPUs, they just launched. And basically, we have two choices. You can go for a Core i9 9900K,
yeah.
Or in this case, with
a 97.
Yeah. K as yeah. well, so overclockable, and yeah, you can manually overclock them in the BIOS. So don't expect too much of overclock because you know it's limited case. Everything needs to be cooled as well. Then the VGA card. I already told you Ventus, and what's quite interesting here, what we have in I think all our gaming desktops, or most of our gaming desktops, we have vertical graphics, which
mm-hmm.
basically means it's standing straight up.
Yeah.
And yeah, I mean, if you go to a LAN party or something, I don't know the weight of this one.
I think this one.
We can later check
yeah.
it on the website. But anyway, it's
not that heavy.
Not at all. No. So it's very easy to bring to LAN parties or to your friends. And then the vertical VGA is interesting because when you transport it and it's horizontal, you know, VGA cards are quite heavy, and especially with the 20 series, RTX 20 series, they're getting more heavy and heavy because the GPU needs to be cooled quite well. And you don't want to damage the PCI Express slot or your expensive VGA card. So with a vertical slot, we don't put any weight on the VGA card, so we prevent that. Did
yeah.
you already...
Someone is asking if the top model is also going to be sold in Spain.
Yeah, that's Europe, yeah. so yeah, yeah. You need to check on the website. Later I will show you what's available in which countries, let's say in which regions, and then Spain is part of Europe, so yeah, we have a top model with the 2080 Ti. I don't know, let's see in a few slides.
And I think it's also coming to the US soon, right?
Yeah, absolutely. I think it's already available in the US at certain stores. It's shipping for Europe and APAC, to be honest. I don't know if I have any concrete data. Some benchmarks. And I think you saw Peter in the last few weeks, and me as well, talk enough about the RTX series. And if we classify RTX series, I think 2070 and 2080, they are for 4040p. And I think Michiel also showed it. Talking about monitors, that you know, you have 4040p, but you can also do 144Hz, and you know that, or 1080p 144, and that needs extra performance. So basically,
yeah.
if you do 144 on 1080p, you need more than two times the performance of 1080p.
Yeah, that's gonna be really hard to squeeze it out.
Yeah. So you for you this is important, right? I'm more the graphic
yes.
guy.
Well,
I like
well,
nice graphics.
Well, yeah, because you know VPS for me is really important, and in VPS you know that open 1 second can really make you know the world of difference. So for me, you know, I really prefer you know the highest FPS possible.
Yeah, I hope you're not too good in Call of Duty when we.
I didn't practice that much, so
I practice
okay.
a lot. I don't want to. Yeah, I want to beat him.
You'll be okay.
Yeah, you tie one hand behind your back.
Yeah, sure, I'll play with my feet.
Okay. So I think this is typical for 4040p, this graphics configuration. If you want to do 4K, then I suggest you to go with a 2080 Ti.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, because that can do 60 FPS at 4K in most current games. Of course, we don't know it for the future. And you can always go for an SLI setup, but yeah, this one is not available in SLI. Then you need to go for the EasyStiI 3 we showed in the
yeah.
beginning. Did you already post a link?
Yeah, I did several times, so I think we have quite a few people lined up and we can already see if there's a winner.
Yeah, maybe give away
yeah.
one code already.
Yeah, so let's see if we can draw a lucky winner.
Yeah. Me? Am I also inside?
Well, it depends.
Yeah.
I think you own all the codes, right?
Yeah, that's true as well. Yeah.
Draw winner. One.
Yeah.
Two.
Please mention only his name.
Yeah.
Because yeah, GDPR, we don't want to give away all the email addresses and etc. Erik van Beuren. No,
that's not you. So we have a winner, and his nickname will be Massive Attack.
Massive Attack, congratulations.
Yeah. So congratulations
probably from
you.
YouTube, yeah. Or from Twitch can also be.
Not from Facebook, because I think you will be blocked if you use nicknames over there.
And I don't think we have that many contestants yet. So guys, please go to the link that I have been posting in the chat so you can also...
Maybe post a couple of more times.
Yeah. I'll keep posting it, so please just participate.
So the link we are showing on the screen, msi.com/2/insider, doesn't work at this moment. So we're using a Gleam application for the giveaway. So Ja will post this once more in the chat. Please, you can also pin it.
Yeah, I'll try to.
Oh, Michiel, can you please pin the YouTube link at Facebook?
Let me see.
Yeah,
I'll try.
Okay, perfect. And I think, Ja, maybe go back to the slides. Sorry. Yeah, so Silent Storm Cooling Tree is also an important feature. And we see a lot of desktops on the market, you know. They have a lot of high-end components, but they don't think about cooling. So what we try to do with OR, and this is not only this model, but this you can find in all MSI gaming desktops.
And someone is also asking if this model will be available in India.
Yeah, but to be honest, I don't know any dates for APAC and then CIMEA region. So sorry, but yeah, for sure, in a couple of weeks, months, it will be available in India as well. No doubt. About cooling, we designed this model so it has three different compartments. So you have the PSU is separated from the mainboard, where you have the CPU, and that is, those both are also separated from the VJ card.
Yeah.
And normally, I always say, you know, what is the most hottest component? What do you think? What would you?
Well, if I have a beast that's a nice generation of Intel, then I think I'm definitely gonna go with a CPU.
Yeah, I always say based on power draw, it should be the GPU, the VJ card. But I think you're right. You know, nowadays it's the Core i9. It can go, you know, not TDP, but based on heat, it can probably go above 100 degrees.
Especially if you look at, the heatsink on the VGA, it's just massive.
Yeah, indeed. So, with this, you know, we use big fans, you already saw it. It's silent as well. So this is our lineup. Next slide is about pricing and the configuration. So this is our lineup. So you see this is more for the enthusiastic people. So for the high-end segment, there we have the Infinite X, Trident X. And besides the Trident A, X is always about overclocking. So we use a Z chipset, Z370. So that's in this segment. If you go to the performance segment, the middle segment, we have there the Infinite A. Later we will also have Trident A and Trident 3, the small one Ja showed you. This is all with the B chipset, so B360, B250, this kind of segment. And then at entry level we have the Infinite and we have some Infinites with H310. And then, you know, normally you find them with a Core i3 SKU or more entry-level CPUs and GPUs as well. But Trident X, once more, let me show the next slide. So this is an indication, so please don't pin me on the pricing because and the configuration for that matter. For us, it's always very difficult to collect all the SKUs from worldwide and all the pricing information. So I just want to give you a general idea. So first of all, US, we have three SKUs shipping. One of them is with the i9. Oh, you see, I made a mistake. I said i9 9700K.
It should be i7.
It's i7 indeed. Yeah. Anyway, my mistake. So 9900K, 16 gigabyte of memory, RTX 2080, 512 gigabyte SSD, and 2 terabyte hard drive. So I believe your first question will be, why no 2080 Ti? Well, at this moment, they're very, very hard to get.
Yeah.
So they're shipping. Yeah, it's really shortage indeed. Or popular demand, or both, you know. But anyway, it's very difficult to get them. So I know they're available, but so later, probably in all the markets, in all the SKUs, we will also add the 2080 Ti. Because it fits in here, not only based on size, but also based on thermals. So then we have one with a 9700K, and for the rest is the same configuration, only a smaller, different CPU and smaller SSD. And then the entry level one, which is about $2,000, and for the US, I think it's without VAT, each state has their own VAT. Let me see, 9700K, 16 gig, 2070, and that will not be with 2070 Ventus, but with 2070 Armor. And there we don't have a hard drive, it's 512 gigabyte SSDs. Ja. Can you maybe move your head a little bit?
Yeah, like that, sorry. So for Europe, again, we have three SKUs, one with 9900K, two with i7 9700K, 32 gig, so more memory for Europe, RTX 2080, and the bottom SKUs with 2070, and then you see the SSD, the storage configurations. So it's 512 gigabyte SSD, 2 terabyte hard drive, and then the entry level one is with 256. So pricing is, let's say, 2400 euro, including VAT. And you know, there are countries who have like 27, I think Nordics has Sweden, probably 27.
Yeah, Sweden.
Yeah, it should definitely be like 27% VAT. Holland has 21%, and I'm sure there are countries who have like 18.
No, I think they're even higher than that.
Holland not.
No, not Holland, but I mean
yeah.
Nordics.
Yeah, yeah. Anyway, you know. Yeah. So that's a lot of percentage to add. And these pricing, indication pricing is including VAT. So that's for the SKUs. I'm going to connect this one. Let me collect all the cables. And then I'm going to show you some software. Let me see. Too many cables. Yeah.
So guys, please, if you can't see the giveaway link, just tell us in the chat, and I'll try to show you the other ways.
Yeah, no. The site is not working, so you always need to post it. Just post it.
Yeah, but some people are still saying they can't see the link somehow. But I think maybe I'm just misunderstanding him. But
oh,
I think it's being handled.
Yeah,
it's being handled properly.
Cool. That means Jeroen fixed it. So LAN, and this is the display port. I'm missing. Okay. Now let me take this cable.
Someone is saying they have 30% of tax.
Where?
I'm not sure. It's he didn't say the country.
30% of tax.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, it should not be a problem because in the end, the tax is are returned to the people, so probably you have a lot of welfare or
yeah,
healthcare.
The government is doing a good job.
Yeah, indeed.
Let's power it on.
I will capture this.
So like here you this. Can see it once again.
Yeah, so with the panel. Let me boot this up. So, yeah, later I will show you some benchmarks. I'm also going to play with Jar and against Jar. And you, Call of Duty, Black Ops 4, so you played it. I'm Battlefield, everybody knows.
I played Call of Duty quite a few times back in the days when they were like, you know, the classic titles like Modern Warfare and stuff.
That's
and,
a long time. I only played
a long time.
Yeah, that's a long time ago. I only played the single player of. Yep. What did you already have multiplayer at that moment? Sounds like pre-internet.
No, I don't think so, because that's a really long time. I believe that's like 8 years ago, at least.
Yeah.
At least. Yeah. And then I switched over to Battlefield, and as you've noticed, maybe, you know, there's always like a little conflict between Call of Duty and Battlefield players.
Yeah.
So
so
that's
you know
how you perform.
Yeah. Well, actually, I like it.
Yeah, I mean, the game
it's
is good.
A hot game, and especially Blackout, the new game mode.
Yeah. And all the streamers are really starting to stream this new edition.
Yeah. So let's have a look at the desktop. Not sure if capturing works.
Yeah, and you can also make a chance, of course, with this title. And all you have to do is just register, and maybe you can be one of the lucky winners.
Yeah. So maybe you can go to the desktop.
So it's booted up. Okay, let me see.
Yeah. So yeah. No. So what I'm going to show you, first of all, Mystic Light. Mystic Light is basically the name for our software which controls RGB LED. This is a new version. Still, it's not 100% final, which means, you know, new versions are still being developed, new features, etc. As you can see here, I selected, you can see the mouse, yes. In the top middle, I selected the Trident X. You can also select the keyboard. I have here GK70 of GK80 connected, and you select the mouse GM70. So this all can be synced, and not only with, for example, these are MSI keyboard and mouse, but you can also sync them with Corsair, Steel series. You name it. We have a lot of vendors. We support the whole ecosystem.
And if you plug it in, everything can be controlled from this app.
Yeah, which is really user-friendly.
Yeah, so...
And we also have a question. Somebody's asking if it's a good choice to... because he's already he has the Infinite 8 right now.
Okay,
and he wants to know if it's a good choice to, you know, have to upgrade to...
Yeah, that's a good question. So I always tell the people, you know, it depends mainly on your needs, indeed. And mainly on the VGA resolution you plan to play. Because, I mean... If you're now playing 1080p and you have the Infinite A, there are different SKUs. I think 1070, 1080, 1060. 1060 probably is already enough for 1080p gaming.
And 1080, but if you go higher than...
No. So it depends a lot on your monitor. If you're using, for example, I have now I have the MPG 27 CQ.
Here,
This one. So that's with 4040p, and I personally prefer everything to play in ultra settings or high settings, depending on the game. And you know, more than 60 FPS. Sorry?
You have good taste.
Yeah. But I like nice graphics. You know, it's not like the FPS like you like 144.
I think, you know, there's always like a discussion between people that are saying, you know, it's about the story or something.
It's actually, it's do you want to be on the top of the story bar or on the score bar or on the bottom?
Exactly.
You will later see, I don't care about KD, I'm more like spray and pray.
Spray and pray.
Yeah, that's how you say it. Okay. So, a little bit about the software. So, let me collect this, the Trident X, you see it here. You already see something going on, and you can select here rainbow, for example, and then apply, and then you see the colors change. And this also happens here with the model. Maybe you can switch, yeah.
Yeah. There's also someone asking about if we they can sync it with Razer Chroma.
To be honest, I don't think so. I know we're talking with them, and I'm not sure if this is already possible. Razer. I need to check, but like SteelSeries, Corsair, Cooler Master, AMD coolers, you can check our website. A lot of different peripherals or components are syncable. And this is quite difficult, you know. Everybody thinks, yeah, just put a picture in the software and it works.
Yeah,
no, because
there's a lot more to that.
Yeah, everything has their own controller. Everything has their own effects. Everything has their own type of LEDs. And there's their limitations. So and they need to have an API. We also have an API. We even have a SDK, so everybody can develop for Mystic Light if they want. So I think everybody is trying to work everything together. But unfortunately, there is no international standard for this. So everybody is doing their own way and trying to glue it together. And gluing, you know,
doesn't always work.
No, it does not always work.
It's going to be a lot of complications.
Yeah, so that's why we also need to test everything. So this is the rainbow effect. You see it switching. I'm going to select another one. Breathing.
Maybe we can see it better here.
Yeah, so it's going slowly on and off. I will select lightning. Yeah, I already selected it. But then you see a flash with it. You can even let me see rainbow flashing. So each time it will do a different.
Same. But you can also see that the front is also doing the work.
The front indeed. I think like this.
Yeah. So it's not always just a side panel.
It can also go based on music. I don't have any music song here. Can you sing?
Not right now, I haven't practiced.
Okay,
so next time.
Okay, good. So, a lot of effects, I didn't count them. And you can also change the colors to what you want. So, this is green, for example.
Here on the detail, okay, well, the green is, as you can see, it's having a little bit of complications because of the green screen. So,
why did I pick green?
It's okay.
I'm a rookie. Blue, that's the blue.
Let's see how blue looks. Yeah. And. That's a lot better.
So that's basically Mystic Light. And very important, you can also switch it off. Can you maybe see that in the camera? Off. So the fan is not off, but you know the RGB LED is off. I know Not everybody likes it, so please let us in the chat know what you think about Mystic Light and RGB LED. I think it's great, you know, it gives the you know, it gives your gaming room a nice atmosphere, your PC a nice look and feel, especially with transparent glass. So that's also why I'm going to put it on again. I'm going to put it at default to have some nice effects. So that's for Mystic Light, one of the apps. Another app is Nehimic, and I already told you we have Audio Boost, and Audio Boost is the hardware part of the audio, which basically means we have audio capacitors which give a really warm sound. We have a high-end ALC1220 audio codec, high-definition audio, different layers in the PCB that left and right channel are split. So that's Audio Boost. And then for MSI we have something called Nehimic, and Nehimic is quite interesting. I'm really, you know, these guys are really smart. It's a French company. We had a live stream with them a long time ago. Maybe we need to invite them one more time.
I think so.
Yeah, it's you know,
because they're doing some great work there.
Yeah, they started as sound engineers for the aerospace industry. Aerospace, no, flight industry, I should say, you know.
Yeah.
So for jet fighters and the pilots who train in the simulators, they need really good audio, because if they get shot down in real life, you know, they don't have a second chance. Luckily we have, but so surround sound is very important for that, you know, that you get an early warning where the enemy is coming in. So this knowledge, they also started looking into gaming, and together with them, they developed, or together with us, they developed this kind of app. And yeah, you see here, you have a lot of presets, music, movies, communication, which is Skype, Discord, this kind of a thing. And this is the one I should have as default, you know, gaming, very important one. You can change everything to your own likings, so you can give less noise to voices, etc. You can switch this off. You can make your own profiles. You can switch the complete profiles off, and you can reset everything to the predefined profile. They have an option called microphone. And yeah, to be honest, I don't have a microphone plugged in.
We'll just be screaming at each other anyway, yeah. So.
Help me! Left flank!
No.
Yeah, I guess that will be the case. No.
Yeah, it'd probably be like, Tango 6!
Yeah. So, this is the microphone application, and microphone, I think, you know, a few years ago, 4 or 5 years ago, not so many games were played online. You know, you already had multiplayer games. The internet is getting faster everywhere, and now I think everybody is on Discord, on TeamSpeak, some even maybe still on Skype. A lot of games also, like EA, they have built-in audio settings, audio chat. And a lot of online games, multiplayer games, also team-based. You have team objectives, you can help each other, and if you play with friends in a squad, what we are going to do.
Yep.
You know,
that's the best case scenario.
Yeah, indeed. Then this helps really a lot. But a lot of times, you know, it's very difficult to find a balance between the in-game audio and the voice from your buddies in your squad. And with this, you know, you have options like a voice stabilizer, echo cancellation. So all these kind of options help. And yeah, I'm sorry I cannot show it to you, but this is for the chat function. I know.
Yeah.
No, thank you. And also, yeah, anyway, and you also have for audio conferencing, so it's more like Skype or any professional IP solution. Then we have, so that's for the microphone.
So someone is asking if the air cooling, the airflow in the case, is good enough for a 9900K.
Yes.
Because, you know, he says that standard cooling is not going to be enough because it might cause some throttling, but okay, in our case, with the three compartment airflow.
Yeah, I have to say, you know, that's why I also say you can overclock, but it's, you know, don't expect too much from it, especially not with the i9-9900K, because it's really, you know, it's getting hot, it's using a lot of TDP, so it's a beast on that aspect. And this is a micro ATX, so that's why we have the different components, the different compartments, so you can run it at full speeds, that's all no problem. But you know, there is a limitation on what you can ask from the system. And I think this is the max. So I hope they don't come with a 9990K CPU or something.
Maybe in the future we can, you know, put in some water cooling in there.
That yeah, might. Actually we already have. If you look at our Trident X, it comes with water cooling. If you look at our Aegis Ti3, comes with water cooling for the CPU, I have to say. So yeah, we have this. And a few weeks ago we were also talking about water cooling, so we're now preparing a live stream about water cooling. But this will be probably somewhere middle of December, because we need preparation. But yeah, this will be cool.
Water cooling. Yeah, well, good one.
Yeah. Anyway, let me quickly continue about this. So we have SoundTracker. This is a Qi tool. It visually represents from which angle the audio comes from. Yeah, so this is not for professional gamers. This is more for single player games or people who have a hearing, who need hearing aids, you know. We have it. I personally don't like it. I never use it, but you can if you want, you know. It's like cheating.
Yeah, and I think maybe it's time again for another draw to see if we have another winner.
Yeah, good idea. Maybe put a banner on the screen.
Let's see.
So that other people can also join, so yep. Maybe you draw somebody. So we have a bundle with some of our monitors and some of our gaming desktops, and then we're talking about this machine, this new baby, Trident X. Talk about Infinite 9th Gen and 8th Gen, Aegis Ti3. And then if you purchase that, you also get a Call of Duty code, but we also have some to give away today. So the next lucky winner?
Yeah, we have it. Me? And it's not going to be you. I knew you were going to ask that.
Yeah, sorry.
It's going to be me.
Oh.
Yeah. Well, we have Mandy Haworth. So congratulations to you, Mandy.
Congratulations. Nice. Yeah, it's a really nice game. I'm actually surprised by it. Please. For some people, this link is working. Go to msi.com/2/insider. I think Peter's body, you will see a button. Yeah, it's probably Peter.
Probably.
You see a button, click there and then sign up or join. And then we do a lucky draw.
Yeah.
I closed already Nimic. Anyway, we're finished with Nimic. Yeah. I think that's it. Maybe show some full screen mode. Yeah, maybe show some benchmarks about Call of Duty Black Ops 4. Because we did some benchmarking and it's quite interesting because the game has three different game modes. You have it has like 20 or 27.
Yeah, if you really count everything, there's like a lot. Because but I think the main ones are just limited to four.
Yeah, so you have
three.
Online team play like deathmatch or like
team deathmatch.
Demolition, those kind of
hard
modes.
Points, you know, the classic Call of Duty modes.
Yeah, indeed. I think the classic Call of Duty modes.
The majority of the modes are still the same, but they have left out some old modes and added some new here and there, but majority is still the same.
And then you have the zombie mode. I think everybody knows the zombie gameplay.
Ever since the Black Ops.
You like it?
I only like to play with my friends because then it's fun, you know, because you can just say, you know, hey, I'm watching your six, and then you know you don't do it, and then, you know, you get slayed in the back by the zombies.
Oh, you're that kind of friend.
Yeah, sometimes.
Sometimes.
Yeah, sometimes.
Okay. I will keep in mind when we play this game.
All right, you should.
Yeah, that's the zombie gameplay, and then something new, they added Blackout. And I think that's the big hit. It's getting a lot of traction on Twitch, on YouTube.
Because Battle Royale is just, you know, nowadays, it's just...
So this is the Battle Royale game mode. You played Battle Royale before?
Actually, I tried PUBG here and there, but didn't really stick to it. And of course Fortnite. I have to say, I tried Fortnite. I think everybody tried Fortnite at some point.
I'm level 3 Fortnite.
Yeah, you are.
So I got 3 times killed.
Level. Oh, I see.
Yeah. And to be honest, I didn't play PUBG because I was afraid to get addicted.
Oh, yeah.
Because I like this concept. But now I'm you know, I like this. Anyway, no, let's talk about the benchmarks, because if we benchmark those separate parts, it's quite funny to see that there is quite a big difference between the zombie mode, the team deathmatch, and then Blackout. So Blackout is quite heavy. You also will see that later. We will play. We will try to play each. I don't want to play the zombie game with you because you leave me alone.
No, let's not do that this time.
Okay, so we will try to play each game mode, and then you see Blackout. You know, it's a much bigger level, open world. So it's a totally different concept. The most of the benchmarks we're going to show you, you know, are done on a different GPU. So we did some benchmarks on low settings, medium settings, and ultra settings, and this all 1080p. I think if you see this, everything is above 60 FPS. So 1080p, no problem at all for this game. Even on ultra settings, 75 frames per second with a GTX 1060.
I think with this piece, it's really just the resolution that really comes down to it in the end.
Yeah.
Of course, coupled with, you know, how ultra your setting is.
Yeah, so this is on ultra settings. This is all on ultra settings and we change the resolution. So we have the same 1080p, but we also add 4040p and 4K. And if you look at 4040p, you know, I think for PC gamers, PC Master Race, you always should have minimum 60 FPS as target.
Yeah.
And then 1060 and 1070 don't cut it. For 4040p on ultra settings. So, you know, if you want to play on ultra settings, you can still lower down the detail a little bit. But 4K is a different story.
I think it's still a bit early nowadays with, you know, the games coming out. They're really not really that well optimized for the 4K.
Yeah, as well, but don't forget 4K is 4 times 1080p.
Yes.
So, and actually 4K. It almost shows in the benchmark. And I have to say, the new cards can handle higher resolutions better than the old cards.
Yeah, because I think the developers have been keeping attention keeping an eye out for the development.
Yeah.
Because, you know, the monitors are getting bigger and bigger and people really want to play in a higher resolution.
Yeah. And also memory. I mean, you look
really
at 1060, you have a... I think this is the
6 GB
version, by the way. So the 3 GB version will have even bigger impact. But yeah, they talk about 6 or 3 GB and then...
That's a big difference when you are talking about high resolution.
2080? 11 gigabytes?
2080, gigabyte, yeah.
Something like that? Michiel?
It's really needed.
Sorry?
2080, 11 gigabyte?
No, 2080 is 8 gigabytes, 2080 Ti is
11 gigabytes. Yeah, 2080 Ti, okay. So, a lot more memory, so you will see that in the benchmarks as well. A little bit about CPU, but this game is also quite CPU intensive.
Yeah,
and
I think especially when you play Blackout, it's with all the other players in the server, it's going to be really CPU bound.
Yeah, indeed. So here you see some benchmarks. If we look at the entry level, we have a Ryzen 220. And basically this is a 4-core, 4-threads CPU. You score 66 average. So the first number is the minimum frame rate. The second number is the average frame rate.
Somebody's asking, sorry, for what the benchmark is of this game.
Sorry?
Somebody's asking what the benchmark is of which game it is. It's Black Ops.
This is Call of Duty Black Ops 4. Indeed, yeah. So later we will do some gameplay with that. You see the top CPU, you're talking about a 6-core 12-thread is doing 140. And the 87, we didn't have time to benchmark the 9900K. You need to have a Core i5 and higher, I would say, to get some decent benchmarks. To not be impacted too much. I think that's it. Maybe you can go to main. Then I will. I think we can play some game, right?
Yeah, and guys, don't forget to participate in the giveaway because we still have codes left.
Let me see. Now, let me see how good you are.
Time for the showdown.
Okay, we're going to play Call of Duty Black Ops. We also have some bundle with this. Oh yeah, you need to change your webcam. Yeah. We had a little bit problem with the webcam, so let's hope it works like that. We hope all the audio this time is okay. We're still working on that, but yeah, each week, you know, we have more time to figure things out, and then I think this week we already have no echo, so that...
which is a yeah, big thing.
Indeed. So, again, we have this Call of Duty bundle. If you buy certain MSI gaming desktops or MSI monitor, you can get this Call of Duty game, really nice game. And yeah, I'm really strange to say that because I'm a big... Battlefield fan, yeah, indeed. I was actually, this Friday I'm off, and people in the office already noticed, so Erik, Battlefield launched. I said, oh, I didn't know. That was just coincidence.
Yeah, sure, you didn't know.
Michiel. Okay, so what we first are going to do, maybe you can switch to the capture. If I boot the game, I'm going to show you a little bit about the settings, because you know, this was what I really was impressed for, because this game, it has a lot of settings, not only for control.
There's a lot of flexibility there for anyone that wants to tweak it to the
max.
Almost to the max.
Yeah, it's not only about mouse, etc., and all the vehicles and all the keys. I'm quite big.
Aren't you?
Well, you know, better. I dropped this webcam. always me. Should be okay, right? Yeah. So, let's talk a little bit about settings. I should not in front of it. I'm going to graphics settings because, you know, we're talking about graphics. So, your refresh rate. I'm playing on MPG 27 CQ. So 144Hz screen, 4040p, but for the live stream I put it at 1920, of let's say, sorry, 1080p, because that's what the maximum what our capture card can do. So if you're watching on Facebook, or maybe you're watching on Twitter, if you want a higher resolution, 1080p, go to our MSI Gaming YouTube website. I think it's pinned on some locations, so you get a higher quality stream. Aspect ratio, what I like here, you know, it shows on the right side what you're talking about, you know, so what you can expect. So I just leave this on automatic. The vertical sync, I don't touch. Frame rate, it's quite interesting. You can also limit it, not only the game, but also the menu. And to be honest, I didn't know why this was, so I checked and then they told me this is because otherwise your PC is the whole time running at full speed, because it can do the game of the menu, it can do the menu at like 200 FPS or 300 FPS, but it doesn't need to, so you know, you can save some power and then your system can cool down a little bit until you start the next round. So quite interesting feature. HDR, we don't have an HDR monitor for MSI yet. That will be something, I believe, for 2019. Looking forward to that. And then, you know, if we have these monitors, I'm also going to check how we can capture that and broadcast it, because that should be quite interesting. But I believe then you also need to have an HDR monitor to watch it. So anyway, that's something for the future.
I think while you're doing this, I'm just gonna go draw another lucky winner.
Oh yeah, slow down.
Because I think we're gonna be heading into gameplay soon, and.
Well, during gameplay we can also, during some rounds we can also do some lucky draw.
A little bit more patience.
Yeah, if there are any questions, just let me know. So you can also select different color profiles, but this depends on the monitor, of course. CPU priority. I put it automatically, which basically means that Call of Duty decides the priority. Basically, it puts Call of Duty at the top. If you put it on manual, Windows will decide. So in Windows, you can put different CPU priorities. Preload shaders, if you put it on off, your game will load much faster, but while you're in the game waiting, you know, to join the level, etc., you still need to load your shaders, which might sometimes be quite funny or annoying, because it looks like textures are not loaded, you know,
some black spots.
Yeah, some black spots indeed, so leave it on. Then we have texture quality. Let me click on this. High. Well, you can see here on the left it's low, on the right it's high. I think everybody knows what texture quality is. But of course, this costs memory. And here at the top, let me do this. You see? At the top, you see the memory impact of this. So the more memory you have, the more higher quality textures you can load. The filtering quality, so this is per pixel shading at the distance, how the textures blend in, you know, on top of each other. Special effects, very important, you know, for grenades, smoke, the particles, but this also costs power, not only GPU, but also CPU power. Model quantity, you can put it to low, medium and high. And this basically is how many polygons the characters or the objects in the game are using. And yeah, I think, you know, with this we can play everything on ultra or on high, so this should not be a problem. The static reflection quality, this is for buildings and environment, and then you have also the screen spaces for water. You know, these kind of small things make your...
really makes your game come to life.
Yeah, indeed. Yeah. And that's also, I'm looking for ray tracing, you know.
Oh yes, definitely.
In a few weeks time, I hope Battlefield will launch. If Battlefield will launch with ray tracing at launch, you know, well, at launch, I think Friday can already play it.
That's going to be perfect for you.
I don't have RTX graphics.
Not yet.
Anyway, then we will plan a live stream and show you ray tracing in all aspects. View distance, very important. Just put it on high. And especially in blackout, I think, this is important.
Yeah, of course, the distance is just insane in blackout.
Always get sniped. Everywhere. Yeah. I hate snipers. the shadow quality. I think if you look at this, the left picture, in the right image, it shows it's a big world of difference. And you also have the dynamic shadows for moving objects, and then you have special effect shadows, and this also you can see on the right side, you know, are very small details, but all those shadows, you know, make it much more blend into the scene.
Definitely.
Weapon shadows, well, when I see my weapon, it's firing, so
you don't need shadow, or do you?
No, I don't need a lot of shadow on my weapon. Global illumination, NVIDIA is always talking about this, should be very important. And quite interesting, here you see, in blackout only. So some of these settings are only for blackout. And you know, we already saw it's quite heavy. And you know, with this you can lower down if you can increase the frame rate a little bit. Anti-aliasing, this is just, you know, the jagged ashes. Ambient occlusion, again, you know, to improve the, I think this has to do with light and shadows, creates soft shadows that can intersect with each other. Motion blur, interesting. What do you think about motion blur?
Definitely a big no-go.
No-go?
No. We don't even have to get started about the pros. I mean,
if I want to win from you, I disable motion blur. Okay?
Yeah, you should do definitely should.
Okay, disable.
I mean, it might make it look like more smooth while we move, but if you really look at it, it's just really jacking up your screen because you can't really see what's going on.
Yeah, I always have when I get, you know, when I'm under suppression, under fire?
Yeah.
You know, you lose focus and...
Yeah. And next time you know you're on the ground.
Yeah. Probably already before that. Subsurface shattering. Okay, I think these options are at the bottom because they're not important. I don't know what this is doing. Makes you more lifelike. Okay, cool. Independent transparency. Order and transparency. Anyway, just leave them. I'm going to click apply. And some other thing I want to highlight. In the interface option, besides all the HUD, etc., what you can see, telemetry is basically, you know, an option to have some FPS counters on the screen. You can show the server latency, I hide it, GPU temperature, and at the top of the screen, the top left, I hope you can see it, not sure if YouTube or some other channel we're streaming is blocking it. You can see the FPS I'm playing at, and you see the GPU temperature. You have graphic content. We do show. So 18 plus, you know. Can we swear?
The swearing jar is not here, so yes, but no.
Okay, I will.
Let's not do it.
If I don't get killed, I don't swear.
Okay, sure. Well, you guys better pluck your ears, because...
So we have zombie cartoon mode, and this is, you know, It turns the cell shading around the zombies, so it looks more like cartoons, and it reduces gore. So basically, it's almost a kids filter.
It's, you still have the action, but limited.
Yeah. Let's. I will invite Ja. Maybe Ja, show the giveaway. And so at top you can find the system specs for playing today. Yep. And yeah, this is the giveaway.
I'll switch back right after this.
Yeah. So again, for the people just joining, we talked about a new Trident system. Later you can rewatch this live stream if you didn't. You can see it at the bottom. We also have a bundle with this system. So if you purchase one system, you get a free Call of Duty Black Ops 4 code. And we also have some to give away. So Ja, who's the lucky winner?
Yeah, and the lucky winner is Edward Carabas, if I'm speaking it correctly.
Should be fine.
Congratulations, yeah, Edward.
Cool. Yeah. So maybe you can put the link a few times more in the chat. So we were posting a link. You can also go to msi.com/2/insider. There will be a button. If you don't see it, use the link Ja is posting in the chat. And sign up. Later we will do some more lucky draws. But first we're going to do some gameplay. I'm going to beat Ja. Maybe, but probably not. You know, he's like pro gamer.
Wait, what? What?
Not?
What am I missing here?
What are you in what is this game called?
I have no idea. Isn't this Fortnite?
Yeah. Okay, first I will invite you. Let me take my headset.
Time to get real.
Everything still okay?
Perfect.
Perfect. Ah, that's what I like to hear. I invited you.
All right, time to join.
It looks like 2 Black Ops 2, but it's 4. 2, 1. 1, 2, 4. Okay.
That's probably higher than my level in Black Ops 4.
Yeah. So, first multiplayer?
Some deathmatch?
What do you want to do? Deathmatch?
Yeah. It's a good warm up.
These are the different modes. You have core modes like control, heist, free for all. It's locked? It's locked. Oh, I need to be alone, okay. Kill confirm, so basically you need to take this dog tag. Search and destroy, find a bomb. Domination, hardpoint. Hardpoint means you need to capture some sections in the game. And team deathmatch. And then you also have hardcore mode. Basically the same, but hardcore. I'm not sure what hardcore means here, but probably you get less life and one bullet kills you.
Yeah, and no HUD.
Oh yeah, no HUD, yeah. Yeah, no map, etc. Okay, so we're going to play some team deathmatch. Fight match. Good luck. I assume you're on my side.
I don't think we have friendly fire, so.
Oh, that would be maybe in hardcore mode.
Yeah.
Oh, I like friendly fire.
Let's try that next time.
Can I already complain about my setup that it's not like at home that I need?
Yeah, we're not gonna expect too much.
Okay. What if we give away a game code each time I'm on top of the leader?
What? Do you guys agree with that?
Better don't do it. Yeah, they will not get a lot of game codes. I'm sure of it. Okay, so this is in the jungle. You ready? You have audio problems?
No, just turning on my sound. No excuses from my side.
Okay, so you need to choose a character. I always choose Ajax because
stack up, wait for my gun.
So I you know, if I each time switch class, it's difficult, it's very difficult to master. So I'm first trying to do this one. Not sure how it goes, but you know, the special abilities are very difficult to use. Not difficult, but you always need to have the right timing. And I, you know, you will see. Anyway, wish me luck.
All right.
Team deathmatch. Work your frag lists.
What's quite strange is that I hear music during the.
Not following.
is. You don't see anybody? I'm behind you. Don't shoot me.
Friday.
I was on fire.
Nine banks, good to go.
You have my back?
I try. You have a big back.
Do that.
Tactical reinforcement available.
Maybe everybody's left to serve.
Our tactical point beacon has been destroyed.
Yeah. Can you do it?
No, I can.
Yeah, you can. Yeah. Okay. I will. One moment. I will try.
Attack deploy beacon planted.
Should be better.
Our attack deploy beacon has been destroyed.
Hostile blind.
Come on. We're pulled ahead. We're losing the fight.
Come on, he had backup.
Yeah, we also should.
Okay, where are you?
We have the advantage.
Dropped there.
You have the advantage, not because of me. Again, fire.
RCXD standing by.
Probably getting sniped. Come on, I'm reloading. The whole time I'm catching fire. Anyway, I have this cool racing car. I can blow up enemies, but they should not see me coming because they can kill this racing car. It's like a C4 car. Yeah, see, somebody already.
Ah.
Oh.
Trigger weapons.
Yeah. No way.
I was just going there.
Not good.
Hostiles have taken out our attack deploy beacon.
Before I see some enemies. Yeah.
Hostile forces have destroyed your RCXD.
I'm not a pro player. You're doing good! Come on. Maybe you should read the comments.
That was a 3v1. Nice.
Come on. Oh, this is the fire guy. So he probably killed me 3 times already.
Are you shooting back?
9 bang going in.
Okay, that didn't help.
Ruin kill.
Always the sniper boys.
Damn. So you're. Score is like double.
I have to check my score.
Can I walk behind you?
Where?
How goes that?
Come on. Rocket slam, I guess. I don't have a secondary weapon. So when I switch, I have my fists.
Yeah, me too. I couldn't choose a secondary weapon.
Yeah, probably you need to upgrade.
Oh, backstab.
Hey, kill! Kill. Lucky.
Ooh.
taking the lead.
That's a kill.
Yeah, you got it.
Our tactical beacon has been destroyed. Enemy UAV above.
How can I climb?
Above you.
Nine going out. Blinded him. Hostile down.
Oh,
nice.
I have this weapon. Oh, this.
UAV standing by.
I need to hide for this weapon, for this car.
Why do they shoot at women? It's not cool.
No. I hope I can. Oh, yeah. Yeah, cool.
Ruin requesting UAV tasking.
Tempest, shut down.
Yeah. I need to go more for headshots, I mean.
I'm using my trigger weapon now. Let's see what this brings.
Shotgun.
Well, there was
one. I have this this shield. Q. I'm going to press Q when I see some enemies.
Also, that's your trigger. Shield.
Yeah. Well, I have a flashbang. Works quite well.
Joy beacon online.
I don't know what what happened there.
Hostiles are taking our attack deployed.
Ballistic shield pushing through.
Where are you? No, I'm killing a guy. Yeah, you cannot walk fast with a shield deployed.
But it actually does stop bullets. Doesn't it?
Hey.
We won!
Well, what we were paid to do.
Your KD is higher.
Okay.
Well,
how did I
this do? Is not me. One.
I think we did an awesome job. For Call of Duty newbies.
Yeah. Well, I'm no new newbie. I practice all week.
Yeah. What level are you?
20 something. I don't know. Whoa.
Oh, somebody said we should stop dying.
We should what?
We should stop dying.
Yeah. But how?
Great
tips
game.
Are welcome. So, let's have a look. Well, we're not last. We didn't finish last.
No, not at all.
Your KD is higher.
Lucky game.
Score. Yeah, you did better. Oh, you can see here. So I killed 14 people and died 11 times, and you killed 17 people and 13 times. Cool. Check this guy, 25, 13. 23, 14. So this one is better. Wow. But they're level 43 and 47, so we have some practice to do.
Alright.
Check this level 3. Oh, that's you.
Somebody said that should be worth 2 codes.
Okay, so let's try. I don't know, what's the time?
I think we've been playing this now 2 minutes in. It's now 5:20.
5:20. Okay. Then, it starts another round.
Started.
Same level. You want to go same level? It's not nice that we leave now, right?
No. Actually, it would be nice to change my class, but it doesn't seem to allow me.
Now you can select on the top right. Top right.
Oh, right.
No, top right. Oh, you.
No, I mean this. My loadout.
Oh yeah, you can select one, but you need to be quickly.
Yeah, let's go for this. Do I have secondary? Good.
I hope not to miss with my primary weapon that I don't need the secondary.
Oh, it's only for emergencies.
Yeah, I had quite a few.
Team deathmatch. Government troops, liquidate all hostiles.
Probably I'm walking in a trap where everybody comes at me.
We have the advantage.
We have the advantage.
Yeah, just. Did you?
Ah, first kill. Yay.
Come on.
We're losing the fight.
Nine bang ready.
I feel like I'm camping, yeah.
We're winning this.
You know what's new for me in this game? It's all the jumping.
Yeah, people really like to jump and shoot. It's like rabbits with guns. Rabbits with guns.
Oh, that's probably not good.
Attack to play the horrible
B movie.
Nine bang going in.
Where are the people? I need to fire some bullets.
Whoa, I missed all.
Enemy UAV above.
I missed really. I started aiming to the left and then this person was going control. To the right.
Well, I got finished by a camper, so.
I'm really.
Another camper, nice.
Net call, hostile hailstorm inbound. Ooh.
Okay, I got one. Okay. Thanks. I got an upgrade. I'm now level 25.
Nice. But,
yeah.
What am I?
I don't deserve it. Let's say it like that.
Look at that. They're gone.
I keep getting finished off by campers. It's unbelievable. Okay, that one's not camper.
Oh, jumper. Yeah, really good. I need to follow you. I mean, they're really good in team play.
Yeah. I got a feeling like I chose the wrong weapon.
That's what you said last game. are we following each other?
Oh. I'm not sure.
You know, the moment I know I need to dive away, I'm dead. So basically, I think too slow.
Or they're just too fast.
Assault packs down. Come get it.
I think the semi-automatic snipers are really strong. And they're
taking the lead.
They can kill you like 4 or 5 minutes.
Time bang going in.
Yeah, steal my kill. Ooh, panic. I had panic mode. This means I was not aiming.
The 180 wasn't so successful.
Oh yeah.
Attack deployed beacon has been destroyed. Sensor dart away. Hellstorm Lord authorization.
That's one strong doggo.
I see a dog.
Yeah, there's a K9 running around. Don't be near it.
And now it's a K0.
Threat spotted.
Why do they call it K9? Oh, come on. Okay. Mental note, I should not stand still.
Jump around.
Oh, so you are the game who is lifting up his mouse. I see you doing the whole time.
Yeah, I have really slow sensitivity.
I'm always, you know, I have high sensitivity. Oh, yeah. I also never know what I should do first. Revive or reload.
If I play on high sensitivity, I'm basically a potato sitting there to be killed.
Nine bangs up.
A potato, yes.
I should revive. No, I should reload first. Yeah, come on! I knew he was still there. Let's check. See how he's doing?
Not a good game.
No.
This is not a good
game. What is this?
Oh, Jesus.
Oh!
RCXD in your AO.
I like to walk the other way, hoping they spawn here. Not that I want to spawn kill them, but you know, I can flank them.
We're losing the fight.
Lead the charge.
Friends. What is the blue smoke? Airdrop or something. Yeah, that's how slow I am. I saw somebody dying and I was still aiming.
Our attack deploy beacon has been destroyed.
Yes, finally a kill.
Nine bang out. Ruined. Drift down.
Missed him completely.
Hostile RCXD spot.
Ah, there.
You're in trouble now.
Taking this. Push now.
Nomad kill.
Okay, I need to improve on how to use my shield. I'm not sure.
Enemy hellstorm detected.
Whoa! Oh, no, no, no! I think they have like warplanes or something. Nah, it was for you not a good game?
No, it was a very bad game.
My KD is... yeah, you have the wrong weapon. Switch back to the alt kit.
I don't know, somehow this game is just like snipers. Can't protect them. Okay, I lost a lot of medals too.
Nice headshot. So this is probably like DMR or something. It's not a... No, it was not a sniper rifle.
No, it was semi-automatic.
Not a single bolt. You see, Michiel brought me another drink.
Yes,
that's good. Oh, I unlocked a weapon, KN57. Not sure what I can do with it. Thank you. Defeat. Let's go here. So I had... Yeah. You see my practice? It worked well.
Yeah, that was very clear.
Let's bring party.
Yeah. Let me see.
What's it? Select? I don't know. Oh, you need to read that. I never read things. Continue. Back. This is quite funny. Select, you go back. Back, you go back. Continue, you go back. Nice. Okay. Let's do a little bit blackout.
Oh, blackout. It's time for blackout.
Yeah, so are we going duo?
Yeah.
I have to warn you, probably means that you need to play 20 minutes alone, because I will die at the first...
How about we just stick to each other like a team?
Uh-huh.
And we die together.
Mm-hmm.
Sounds good.
That's a good idea. Anything on the chat?
No, nothing. Just a lot of comments about stop the nuke spraying and give her the other screen.
Yeah, they're looking at me.
And a lot of requests for the giveaways. That's good.
Yeah.
Yeah. Keep registering.
Yeah. This won't take long. So... you know, this... I need to think this game mode. What is the best strategy? You can hide until the end, so you get number two. Do you get points
for
that?
No, you don't get points.
And then if you're lucky, you kill the first one.
Yeah. I mean, it all depends on, I think, what do you want to achieve?
You see, the shaders are not loaded. Oh, no. No, the shaders were not loaded.
I mean, we're probably not going to just sit there somewhere and just wait for the viewers. That's going to be really boring.
Oh, what I always hate is if I find a...
Don't run, come on.
If I find a weapon which is like a shotgun, a close... Where did he go?
Where did he go?
Well, you know, this is for round start, so you cannot kill anybody. I will come to you.
So let's show some parkour skills.
You have skills? Cool skills?
Parkour skills. Oh, there are actually people that are really well dressed.
Yeah, some skins. Are you on the roof?
No, I'm staring at someone with a really fancy costume. Yeah,
okay.
Actually, I think this guy or girl has our dragon on his costume.
Oh yeah, cool. Oh, you're outside?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's too late for me to walk outside.
Maybe.
Yeah, I can still see it. Where is the lady?
Here.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah, dragon. Nice, cool. Mm. So,
where are we heading to?
Yeah. The map? This river town. So,
infiltrate, engage, and destroy.
I don't know where it is. Check the map again.
Eric is Dutch, he's not French. That's the second mark we got.
That's a compliment! Okay, so we go where the marker is on the screen. You go fast. Okay, I go fast, like this.
Actually, you jump out first. Okay, where's the mark?
Yeah, I don't think a lot of people will go here, so we can find plenty of weapons.
River town.
Oh, go to the right, to the right, to the right. I see a lot of people jumping left side. Probably not a good idea what I'm now doing.
So, anybody there?
Oh, I'm opening up this door. That's not smart.
Let's grab some stuff.
Yeah.
I'm in the other building.
I will join. I have a shotgun. I mean,
there's a semi-automatic here, bandage, and
I told you I hated shotguns, right?
We can switch.
Potential collapse detected. Relocation to indicated safe zone is advised.
Oh yeah, I have now let me tap.
Oh, there are plenty of rifles here. Come here. Here, on the ground.
Yeah, I had this. Well, probably better. Oh. I don't know what it all means. This shotgun. I need a scope. I picked up a scope. Oh, that's a nice, I guess. I picked up a scope, but I dropped it on a weapon, I guess. I'm not sure how this works. Let me see. So, I have no scopes here, no scopes here. No, I need a scope.
That was not supposed to happen.
What? Did you explode?
I threw something by accident.
Oh, this is my secondary weapon. I have the scope on this.
Somebody is already taking fire at me.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I will come help. Wrong way. Are you winning?
I'm down!
Come on.
I gave him like 3 headshots. He didn't go down.
Where is he?
Last man standing. Bring this home.
Hey, you died!
Ah, oh, shit.
Sit rep. Circle collapse imminent.
No!
I died!
See, we died together.
I knew he was inside.
I think there were multiple people because I got attacked from another angle.
Yeah. Around the corner somebody was trying to snipe me. Kill cam, let's have a look. I probably missed, I just didn't aim. But this is him. Hmm. That was you? That's why you died so quick. I was like,
yeah, hey. you were backstabbing me.
He had a way better aim. Okay, leave match. I mean,
Are you supposed to watch this, how it continues?
I don't think so. No, you don't have to.
Yeah,
I left choose already. To, but you don't have to.
No, but I'm like, oh, yeah. So these, for me, these runs are quite quick.
Yeah, I mean, we're still new at this, so.
Yeah, I am. You see me level 2, 0-0, 0-0-0. Yeah, I get some points from doing nothing. Maybe you can show the specs, what we're playing on. So today we're playing on the new Trident X. Trident X comes with a, well, there are the specs. This one is with a i7-9700, 2080, RTX 2080. A lot of memory. And we're playing on GK80 keyboard and MSI GM70. And we're starting again. Another round. Let's see how. Should we have a stopwatch or something?
I'll try to keep track of the time.
Okay, so really stick together because I was. I was in a different. I left you alone.
Yeah. We're getting stuff, so that's okay.
Yeah, but we really should be glued together like a team because.
Yeah.
Otherwise I could probably either have killed him or maybe revived you. And he now could just jump into...
So there was a question and yes, Eric is playing on the Trident X system.
Yes. But, yeah. Oh, I have a sniper rifle. I never played with that, is it? No. Give me a head. Out. Quite fast. Same location?
Yeah, sure. Somebody wants to know if, in case he changes any part in the computer, if the warranty is
still. That's a very good question. If you upgrade it, no. You can just upgrade the system. But of course, you should not damage items. Oh, we drop from a different angle.
Oh, yes, apparently we are.
Anyway.
River Town, okay, that's gonna be that's right.
You need to go to the right.
Yeah.
You seem to be flying fast.
Oh, you were way behind me. I'll try to find out where all the good stuff are. Somebody is in front of me.
I'm already dropping my parachute. Can you maybe
different location?
Different location.
Let's go to Tracking Tower.
Far away, far behind you.
Then let's meet at the blue spot on the map. You see the blue spot?
Sorry, I'm collecting weapons. Yeah, I see. Still don't have a weapon.
Oh, I see you have already landed a long time ago.
Still
potential collapse detected. Relocation to indicated safe zone is advised.
I get a lot of scopes. Is this level one? Level one. I get a lot of ammo. And this is secret stash. No. Infantry full. I need to get a backpack again. Scope, laser sight. This one I already did, I guess. Yeah.
Don't seem to be able to use the scope that I just picked up.
Yeah. They might be incompatible.
That's a shame.
There are no weapons here. Do they expect me to
fight with your
face? Oh, I have a weapon. Of course, it's my favorite one. A shotgun.
Why do you always get a shotgun?
I don't know. Maybe they're...
let's see. What can I equip?
Did I go in here? Yeah, I did.
Ooh, 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 ooh.
sir.
Net call. Supply drop incoming.
I'm dead.
I'm coming.
Circle collapse imminent. Get to safety.
Oh, I need to kill him. come on. I was reloading and there was a second guy.
I'm running.
Anyway, I killed somebody. Woohoo! No, I didn't kill.
You put him down but didn't finish him.
Yeah, I was reloading and then one or two other guys jumped in.
But now you're eliminated?
Yeah, a little bit. Half.
I see.
I'm spectating you.
Let's see if I can offend you. Did you die there?
No. Yeah, to the right.
There.
To the right. No, more to the right. To the blue. Did you? No, you put it. Oh, no. I don't know. I don't know.
Okay.
That map. I didn't die here. That's for sure.
That's the circle.
Yeah, so if you... Yeah, you need to go into that direction. Probably fire range, a lot of people waiting for you. Oh, you don't have scope yet.
Actually, I did.
Oh, yeah. Huh.
I don't have that many bullets, I guess.
You have 90 or 60, I don't know. Should be enough. So you need to play like a bunny.
Yeah, I don't want to get shot at. Okay, I'm in a circle. Nobody's waiting for me here. There's still 46 people. Where are they?
Yeah, probably. You know, it's still a big level. Circle is coming in. You know, I never play this kind of game. This what's it called, Battle Royale.
Yeah.
So I always thought the circle was going to the middle, but now I found out the circle is always at random, and then inside the smaller circle there will be another circle which is also not in the middle.
Yep.
Yeah, quite interesting. Hey, that's my favorite gun. I always get that one.
Lucky you.
Don't pick it up. What's your secondary?
This one.
Oh, you probably gave away your position like this.
Yeah, I'm actually trying to lure some people here because nobody is coming. And
I think it's the you need to camp. Because, hey, that's quite strange. Yeah, one, right, two.
Shouldn't have done that.
Health, X.
Uh-oh. There we go. That was smart.
Well. Kill cam. Just to enjoy it one more time. Hey, oh, this is me. Check. One guy over there. I killed him. Okay, that was no pretty sight.
See, they were a tag team. They were running together.
Yeah. True. We can do that. We should do that.
Yep.
Did I... Landing is the difficult part.
Yeah, because I think I noticed we are not starting at the same point in the plane.
Oh, that's also possible. Even didn't get points to damage this one. I do another time deploy. So, yeah, this is a quite interesting game mode.
Somebody saying noob, stick to CSGO.
Yeah, maybe. I don't play CSGO, you play, right?
Yeah. I stick to CSGO, you stick to Battlefield.
Yeah.
I mean, come on, it's our first time playing this game. Well, seriously. Playing it. You can press F1 to open your friends list while in the menus. I don't have any friends, so...
Yeah, you have me. You have one.
Yeah, I don't have to press F1 to see you.
That's true.
Oh, come on. We need some better teamwork.
Yeah, sorry.
No, It's not your fault. I mean, I'm still lost.
This is the strange thing. In this pre-part, I always get nice weapons. Look at this.
And then we start the game, you get shot.
Yeah. Exactly. Yeah, perfect headshots I can give him. He should be dead. Somebody's sniping me, that doesn't matter. Just in time, out of bullets.
Blackout.
So, yeah, I'm playing on Trident X, run smooth.
Mission clock is running. Go, go, go.
Where are we going? Okay,
go, let's go to like a new type. Tunnel Island's really far away.
We could go factory.
Yeah. Let them all jump out first.
Yeah, I'm wondering. If they jump now, are they there before us? Or are the helicopters fast and we jump straight down?
I think that really depends. Let me see. We're almost there. I think we can. Wait, where's it?
Exit!
Just dive straight down.
Yeah.
Should be okay. I think we're the only two here.
No.
Didn't see anyone?
No.
Oh, this is a big place. I think we can find a lot of good stuff. And you can stick to the shotgun.
No, please. Oh! I already hit somebody. Oh, it's you.
Scary during daytime.
I have armor.
Potential collapse detected. Advise relocation to indicated safe zone.
Where are all the guns? Oh, come on. Still no gun. I got a gun.
Yeah?
It's a SMG. I guess it's better than nothing, yeah. Did we scoop upstairs? Yeah, we did.
I have here some more. Ah, I have a scope. Where'd he go? Let me see the circle.
How many
oh my god!
I guess that's why no one's here.
They didn't know that.
We better France. Run.
We need to find a vehicle.
And maybe here's some stuff. Well, it's a mystery to me how fast the circle is going to close.
Well, we better run because I already died one time because of the circle. I didn't have enough health.
Okay, then we can go through here, because it's closed. Something's here.
Somebody
armor.
Or something?
Armor?
I have armor.
Oh! Okay. Got a rocket launcher.
Circle nice. Collapse imminent. Get to safety.
No.
Well, we better run. How do we get out of here? We gotta run.
Yeah, we need a vehicle.
Where do we get a vehicle?
Just start with running. Bridge?
There's a vehicle. Can we get in there? Behind us.
I don't think so. Let me see how fast it's coming. Ah, we have time. There are quads you can drive, and I saw some guys driving on a pickup truck.
Right, pickup trucks. There are a lot of trucks here and cars. Maybe somebody's helping us. No, nobody's helping us with a vehicle. Can't drive a normal car.
You need scope?
Maybe, I don't have scope.
Here, this house has scope. And behind. An extended magazine.
The garage.
We continue?
Yep. 50 people left.
Oh, this looks like a dangerous place. Are we going to cross it?
I think we better just try to walk around it.
Yeah, this house, check it.
Where's the circle? Oh, it's still quite far away.
Yeah.
Oh, sniper. Take it.
Supply drop inbound.
That's good. I have a sniper without...
Yep. Without scope.
Scope.
Gunshots.
No helicopter, right?
No, I heard some gunshot and then two people are down. Where are the people? More gunshots. Interesting.
Okay. Going more to the right. We cross the river. I'm not jumping. I don't have so many health packs, I guess.
The circle is getting real close. We better run.
Oh my god. We will die of the circle.
Come on. Can we cross it without... No, we can walk around it, can we?
Maybe a boat.
Boat?
Yeah, I saw somebody in a boat.
We're never gonna make it.
No, we don't die because the circle will damage you.
Yeah,
just swim to the other side.
I think there's still a long distance before we reach the safe zone.
Yeah, what can we do? Then I call ourselves unlucky, right? Or noobs.
Come on.
We're almost there. Oh, sure. I have a...
Oh, almost, yes indeed.
Further collapse detected. Travel to indicated safe zone.
Oh, you need to help yourself.
Yeah, what I mean with safe zone.
I hope this house is in the safe zone. No, it's not. Oh, I can only use this for your
few
times.
So close.
Yeah, you need to help yourself with X.
Yes.
Give yourself
yes,
help.
Yes. Oh, okay, made it.
Yeah, we are having problems. Run. I mean. Next one is coming within 1.5 minutes, and we don't have health. I only have 3 of those items left.
Yeah, the circle's getting
really. They look like toilet paper. I'm not sure what they are.
Actually, <yeah. laughs>
it's probably bandage. I hear gunfight to the right, or I don't know where.
I have a very OP weapon, so if we see someone, I can finish him.
That's good.
I got a rocket launcher. So
seems nobody was here. I'm going to jump inside. Oh, I have a wagon. Level 1 armor.
For serious gun battles. Oh, so there's a sniper firing at me. Better run.
Where?
I'm not sure. It sounded like he's on the left of me.
Call. Supply drop incoming.
I think he's on the bridge.
check this car.
Sit rep. Circle collapse imminent. Get to safety.
Okay, circle collapse.
This is a nice.
Whoa, behind me.
Where?
I'm down. Other building, one on the. Come on. Yeah. Okay.
There are two there.
Yeah, didn't I mention that?
Maybe I didn't hear it.
Hey, 16. We're progressing.
Oh, we came so close. Still not a kill.
I would like to spectate this. How it? Oh, the steel stuff, dude. Oh, somebody's shooting at him. Two left. Play zombies?
Yeah, I think it's time for zombies. No luck with blackouts.
Oh, these guys, this guy is playing like professional, like looking everywhere. I'm just running. It wasn't that far anymore.
No, we were really close because I think there were like 20 people left.
It's quite interesting to see how they play, you know? I was just walk to the house, jump in and... Maybe these will be the winners. Oh, that was a quad.
So how many people are still
sniper?
18 people.
That side, yeah. So. Oh, nice. He needs to come your way. Yeah, you see?
Be advised, further collapse expected. Relocate to safe zone.
You'll make a 3-5, another one is not close enough, probably alone.
I mean, now it basically just comes down to camping.
Yeah.
Great gear.
Strafe, left and right, top floor. Now,
top down.
12 left. So we switch to the guys in the house. Oh, he has a serious sniper rifle.
Circle collapse imminent.
Keeping his distance.
And I'm still with two. Go to zombies because, yeah, this can...
Yeah, I think we should. This can still take a while. They're just gonna camp now, the closer we get to the winning. Yes, indeed, the blackout does give you a little bit of anxiety. Okay, quit. But I think the overall the game is like really smooth. I think it's quite well optimized. And of course, it helps with such a good machine, but I think the game itself is also very well developed.
Zombies!
Yep.
Laboratorium? I don't know what this all was. Great glass? Holy moly.
From my past experiences with zombies, it's not just, you know, shooting zombies. It's not that straightforward. Because there are some special powers that you can use, and you have to solve a lot of puzzles.
Really?
Yeah, and you have to gather some stuff to, you know, get further in the game.
Feature playlists. Holy. Just do a public match?
Yeah, let's try.
It's with oh, check me.
This almost looks like an RPG. We have different classes, elixirs, talisman.
How did they start with it? I mean, there's totally no connection. I thought this was just killing zombies when you're dressed up like soldier.
Not that simple.
No, indeed. Why you have the... Oh, it looks like a buck. Do you see this?
Oh, yeah.
Ready up. You need to click ready. Or ready up. I'm ready.
Let's go for... Okay. How do I continue?
I'm not sure if I'm ready or not. I'm ready. I'm ready.
Okay. Ready. Yeah. Maybe Mr. Firewoken will lead us the way.
He looks like a badass.
Yeah, I mean, he's level 36.
Check him. Damn. That body armor. Ooh, nice. Ooh, heads flying. Arms chopped off.
This is really different from Black Ops 3.
Yeah, I mean, kids, don't watch this. Looks scary.
I wouldn't mess with her.
No. Zombies.
Somebody's interested in headphones.
Yeah, so. Yeah.
And he wants to know, what kind of, what model, what type it is.
Yeah, so we have we have different headphones. This is the, let me check. This is the GM, of a GH60, and you have the GH70. So you have used the
booster. It's really
hard. Let me do this like this. So you have a USB one, and I have a...
You have a check block.
I need to...
We need to explore every...
Was that you? Okay,
yeah.
So and GH70 is USB, so it comes with the audio deck inside. This guy.
You think this is fun? Why don't you come down here and have a
It also has RGB LED in the side, and this one is just powered with the audio jack, so it also doesn't have any power, and it makes use of your mainboard headset. But for the rest of the time, they come with these pouches inside your ear. You can exchange them. If you go to our YouTube channel, MSI Gaming, and you check MSI Insiders, the playlist, there are some live streams where we go in depth about our gaming gear items.
Solve all
so
their
keyboards,
riddles and defeat
headsets,
all their warriors, and the doorway will be opened.
One is done by Peter.
Fuck! Why did he have to be right? Why did he have to be telling the truth?
So this is the puzzle?
Well, first we have to make money so we can open some doors. You can also buy the pistol here because you have
a
pistol. This better pistol.
For goodness sake, is no one else going to comment on how ridiculous we look? I mean, come on. Honestly, I feel like some kind of Celtic barbarian.
Well, I guess this is going to happen sooner or later.
Senor Shaw, how many fingers am I holding up?
Stab him.
Need to grab more cartridges. These won't last long.
I have no patience for biters or scratchers. Loners.
Okay, we can open the door now.
Where do you see money?
The left.
Oh yeah. I need a automatic weapon.
A contender calls the champion of Daru.
Oh, fire. I'm the one walking in the fire again. I cannot.
Look,
the champion of Daru is slain.
What?
There's a rifle.
No, I do not need to be alive. Thank you. You just made my shit list, pal.
How do I,
Viper and Dragon, ready to be unleashed.
Did you pick up the rifle?
Not pick up, I bought it. Yes.
Is that the same?
Yes.
Oh, you want to pick up this for free?
Yes, continue here. Round 5.
Oh, this looks nice. The champions of Ra are slain! The scepter of Ra. I'm just following you.
I know
Glyphs
are crazy
to
get slapped around like that.
Come on, aim. Oh.
Insta kill. Oh, you have insta kills. How many times can I miss?
Get off shore. Who will say the crazy things if you die on us?
Oh, good lie.
It's funny because the zombie mode, the characters always have some flashy and dumb puns. Some funny lies. Can I explore downstairs? Where are you?
I'm upstairs, I'm trying to get headshots, but they're moving their heads.
Right. Scepter's charged up.
Charge up? Oh, looks. Whoa.
Just wake me up when it's all over. Thank you.
Who's this? Quick revive.
These damn hordes. Rip, hammer, repeat.
Oh, you see all the zombies? That's it. We can rebuild stuff.
Nice guns, but I don't see them yet.
It's really...
It still hurts, I'll have you know. Cheeky little shit.
How much? We have a guy down.
What do I always go down?
Is this you? I'm reviving you. I'm 1, 2, 3.
You're an angel, my dear.
Thank you.
Bonus points.
Bonus points.
Oh, so I'm on the dole now.
Oh, everyone gets it.
Looks like cool.
You pick it up, it's always
fun. Yeah, I'm a real team player. Where's my money?
That's a shotgun, don't want it.
Everything else in the arena looks solid, yet somehow...
It's confusing, so there's also a downstairs. What does 3, 4, 5 and 6 do?
3, 4, 5, 6.
Okay, Shaw.
Yeah, on the right side, the green buttons.
Sure looks like history. That's one of your specialties, right? History?
I have no idea.
Even if it's just because you're...
I'm going down to the bottom? Oh, I should not go alone here.
Yeah, come downstairs. I think the other two are also downstairs.
Yeah, but you guys are really far away.
Yeah. Max ammo.
Nice, max ammo.
That
does what it says on the tin.
How do I revive myself?
Oh, where are you?
That one is right.
You're not with us, are you?
Nope.
Oh. Okay. Wrong guy. Where are you? Where are
the wrong gladiatrix?
Hey, you're revived.
No, I didn't die. I'm like.
Oh, that is right. I swear I can complete taste nuggets.
Can I throw a grenade?
Yes.
Oh, you're losing that hand now.
Nuclear. found. Yeah, they all died now. But they need some revive.
A contender calls the champion of Zeus.
Okay. Round 8, not bad. Okay, where are we going? Downstairs.
Downstairs?
I think so.
Yeah. Where the guy is.
Okay, the champions of Zeus are slain!
This sort of helped on the ship. Sort of.
I'm rebuilding this and...
You did notice I've a weapon, yes? Fires bits of metal, makes big holes.
Oh, so basically the 3, 4, 5, 6 are special powers you can use for yourself.
I signed on for this adventure. I thought it was for my mind. What bloody manual saber.
And can I upgrade my weapon? Like with a... Oh!
I don't think you can. Behind you.
Yeah, you can deal with them.
Somebody get me back on my feet.
Oh, they're really... I don't have ammo left. I'm sorry.
Oh, God.
A contender!
If it was 3 or 4, no.
I think I did it.
You're feeling better, yes?
You're feeling better, yes. Oh, behind you.
I wasn't sure which hypo I used then.
The champion of Odin is slain! Carpenter!
What weapon do you use?
Shotgun, your favorite.
Okay, where are you?
Where are the other two?
Oh, I see somebody. So you open this up and you get more demons?
Sarcophagus!
Not
hopefully
sure.
Nobody's in
knife.
There.
Why would I have? Why would I have like a knife? I mean...
How do I even use the knife? It's gone.
About the place already.
What? This is weird.
What?
I picked up the knife.
Uh-oh.
Alright, Colosseum. Let's see what you got.
What's happening? Oh, that's
I am not Cat-Fowl.
Headshots do it. Oh!
I'm almost out of bullets. I need... another gun now. Yes.
And like that blasted bolt.
Ammo. Oh, I don't have a lot of ammo. How do you
get
more
ammo? Here's a gun. New rifle.
Why would I buy that? I only need ammo.
I'm not sure how you can just get ammo.
I have a question. For you, Scott.
Max ammo. Come, bring it on, Where are they?
But you do seem really invested in finding
them. Are you going to open this?
Why?
Yeah. That fucking letter. He told me things.
Oh.
Things I didn't know. Things I need to learn more about. And the only way to do that is to get him back from that fucking cult.
Yeah. I'm running in circles.
Yes, thank you for that.
Big guy.
Incoming axe guy. Watch out, he likes to throw him.
Sophie! The chemist is closed! Come back later! Sometimes you need a moment like this to remember just how much you want not to die.
Run.
Your dad would be very proud of you. Hell, I'm proud of you. Slice them all to nuggets!
Come on.
You can activate a trap here.
Ow! Sneaky son of a bitch!
Double points.
You know, I've never been this funny, but I'm thinking this straight into soldiers. I'm not sure why these openings are even here. Seems like they harm the integrity of the structure.
Somebody's down, I'm going to help. Oh.
It's very friendly.
And this is just how long we survive or something.
Yeah, actually you can play this until the end of, I don't know how many rounds, so, but I think we're approaching the end.
Bonus points.
Each time they say bonus points, I'm running out of ammo. That's a trick or something. Level 5. Oh, I leveled up.
Fuel by guns.
Straight shooting here. Oh, I'm in a part I never was before. Temple 11. Oh yeah, now I remember. I'm here without enough ammo. Perfect headshot. You don't die? Oh. Oh, I'm dead.
Where can I find you?
At the bottom in the basement somewhere.
You're not showing up on my screen. Are you? Oh, you are. Oh, it's. Where? How do I go there?
Cookie is helping me. Cookie has some sort of magic staff. Maybe I do this as well. Three.
Bonus points.
Oh, this guy. No wonder he likes this. Oh yeah.
Ah, stupid tiger.
I'm about to die again. Purchase. Give me. Well, that works. Yeah, that works. I have a new weapon. So it's a little bit strange to me. I mean, how do we help each other? It's just running around and sometimes some zombies pop up. Oh, what's this guy?
It's the zombies coming like rounds.
Give me.
So each round, like a certain number of zombies come and you have to defeat them so you survive that round and then you go to next round. And the next round is going to be a little different.
I exchanged my gun. I thought I got a really big one back. But instead, a lot of zombies show up. Yeah, give me gun back. Oh, I know! I put my other gun in! Come on! Oh, there it is. Yeah, give me. It has diamonds on it. Yeah. I have a... This one has enough ammo. Oh, I'm dead.
Yeah, and I think we. It's about time.
Sorry?
I think it's about time to show them what we have next.
Yeah? I don't know what the time is.
Carpenter.
So, guys,
Kaboom.
I understand this game is endless. I have a... check my gun.
What?
Yeah, strange, right?
What did you pick up?
I don't know. Anyway, it seems this level can be played for hours.
Yeah.
We're about to finish.
For days.
Yeah. Some days, oh, maybe quit or something, otherwise you die, and oh, it's not nice. Let's continue, just, you know, otherwise these other two people are left alone. Can you switch to main? I'm going to hide myself. Yeah, so thanks everybody for joining. Maybe give my notebook that we do one more key giveaway. Should be. So today we talked about our Trident. Trident X, a really nice game PC. Oh, it was looks like out of battery or something.
It crashed.
It crashed?
Yeah, it crashed.
Why that?
It's just something, give me a blue screen. Blue screen.
Anyway, back. So you can do another lucky draw. Thanks everybody for joining. Next week, let me see, what is next week? This next week? Yeah. So next week, we already talked a little bit about it. Next week we're going to talk about extraordinary creation, and this is about content creators. I died. I need to... Anyway. So we have some nice guests. We will try to have somebody, we're still working on it, but we have somebody who is doing, who's a ZBrush artist, so he's making a lot of content for games and these kind of creatures. We have a DJ who is using a lot of Thunderbolt equipment, and all, you know, they need to have high-end platforms with a lot of memory, with a lot of cores, so we will have the new Intel CPU. On the X299 platform, we will probably also benchmark that. So, but that's all for next week. Thanks for joining.
Yeah, we have a lucky winner. It's going to be Matthew Kings. Congratulations, Matthew.
Congratulations, Matthew. So don't forget, Trident X is on the market. You can check back for what configurations there are. We have a bundle at this moment, not only with Trident X, but also with Infinite and with EGS Ti3. You can check the website for that, and we hope to see you somewhere next week, and I need to hurry up because I'm bleeding out. Anyway.
All right. Thank you, guys.
Thank you, guys.
Cheers.
Bye-bye. I'm really bleeding out.